of luck. Now, our final guest today became known to millions as Dawn Swan in EastEnders, but added a lot of sparkle to an already glittering career when she won Strictly Come Dancing last Christmas. Now, though, she's taken to the stage and is minding her P's and Q's as Eliza Doolittle in a West End production of Pygmalion. Please welcome Cara Toynton. Hello, Cara.
Hello. How are
you? How is it going? Because it's already been on in the West End for a wee while now.
Yes,
hasn't
we've
it?
Been going for about 3 months. Mm-hmm. So it's
you bedded in.
We are bedded in. I'm loving it, and I'm surrounded by wonderful people, and we've got another month and a half, so we finish on the 3rd of September at the Garrick in Leicester Square.
So how did you get on with Rupert Everett? Because he was on the show just before you started, and he didn't have enough good words to say about you, I have to say.
He's been really generous to me, actually, because obviously it could be quite intimidating meeting someone like Rupert, that I've been a massive fan of, watching him on the big screen for years. And when I went for the meeting, the first audition, he sort of put me instantly at ease, and I felt as though he wanted me to do my best, and that was really generous. And ever since, he's just been helpful, and he's one of these people you want to be around, because I love, as you know from meeting him, you love hearing what he's got to say about anything. He's so naughty. And most of the time I'm just in fits.
How is it going? Because it's already been on in the West End for a wee while now,
hasn't
it? Yes,
we've been going for about 3 months. Mm-hmm. So it's,
You bedded in?
We are bedded in. I'm loving it. And I'm surrounded by wonderful people. And we've got another month and a half, so we finish on the 3rd of September at the Garrick in Leicester Square.
So how did you get on with Rupert Everett? Because he was on the show just before you started, and he didn't have enough good words to say about you, I have to say.
He's been really generous to me, actually, because obviously it could be quite intimidating meeting someone like Rupert, that I've been a massive fan of, watching him on the big screen for years. And when I went for the meeting, the first audition, he sort of put me instantly at ease, and I felt as though he wanted me to do my best, and that was really generous. And ever since, he's just been helpful, and he's one of these people you want to be around, because I love, as you know from meeting him, you love hearing what he's got to say about anything. He's so naughty. And most of the time I'm just in fits of laughter trying to keep a straight face.
And how's it going to be when,
he's gorgeous, he's beautiful, man.
How's it going to be when he leaves? Because he's leaving just before the run ends.
Yeah, I'm really gutted. He's leaving, but we've got Alistair McGowan, who I only have just met, and we've started rehearsing yesterday. So it will be, and Rupert said to me, you know, darling, it's nice to try things with a new new actor, and so it will ship shape us up and get us fresh, I'm sure. And Alistair's fantastic, so I'm sure he'll be good. And we've got Diana Rigg, Peter Eyre, some incredible actors. So it's spurring me on, I must say.
I mean, obviously, your parents must be so proud, because what a thing, you know, to be in the West End and in such a wonderful show. But they must have felt at some point, right, we've sent her to, you know, elocution lessons and drama classes. You know, to learn how to speak proper and that. And then your first role is talking in EastEnders.
I know. Well,
banging on.
I mean, I'm an Essex girl, so obviously, you know, I've got an Essex accent. Bouldering, woo! Cockney, good old Essex. I haven't watched the Essex programme yet, so I shouldn't, though, should I? Because I'll be addicted to it. And obviously, my first couple of days in EastEnders, I got used to speaking in that way, and I came home and went, "Mum, I ain't doing it." And she went, "Oh my God, you know, it's addiction lessons." And she was a little bit upset, but obviously, it helped for this part. But the Cockney obviously is so different back then. This was written at the just before the First World War, the turn of the 20th century, and but it's still so relevant today. And it's a wonderful play about the emancipation of women, and it says a lot about that time, and I think people still find it funny.
Do your Eliza Cockney, go on.
So it's I was taught by my voice coach that the Cockney is all long and wide and sort of very narrow, so cup would be cap. So it's all like that, whereas today it's all in it, isn't it? It's very different, the Cockney now, but cap in it. Oh, where's your sanity? And things like that. So it's all very musical. And I think, you know, people could say it's bordering on Dick Van Dyke at times. But the thing is, in those days, they were the entertainment. They didn't have loose women. They didn't have anything. So in the markets outside, that was the entertainment.
And what about your posh voice? How do you do that?
Well, I won't do that now. No, well, I was hoping it was kind of going to rub off on me permanently, but I don't think it has. I think it's just...
speaking voice.
Have I? Oh, thanks, Colleen. I try. I do try to up in it a bit. But, no, I'm loving the posh voice. It's very over
the top. I bet your mother does, don't
she?
She
loves
your
that.
Yeah,
loves
yeah. It. Yeah, for special... It's a phone voice.
No, how, obviously, Artem is, you know, he's used to the whole showbiz existence in terms of, you know, there's long hours and you're on stage and what have you. Has he come to see you at all, or is he busy? Is he touring around the country?
It was really funny. He came to my first night, the previews and of press night, and I said, honey, did you understand any of it? He went, 70% no. So he laughed in all the right places, and he was ever so nervous for me, bless him. But no, he really enjoyed, obviously, what he could understand. And he's busy all the time, so yeah. I guess
we... Do you ever dance together?
Never, Linda.
Oh, you must go out dancing when you finish the play.
I'd love to.
She ain't got time.
Well, because it's his job. Mm. It's unfair for me to get him up. You know, when we do go out, which is very rare, I'm quite boring, but when we do, he stands and he doesn't really dance because it's his job.
He stands around the kitchen and says, oh,
well,
I've
I'm going to start making
I did
it a
that.
Thing.
How
because
lovely.
It's
romantic.
A great husband always sitting around the kitchen. That. But it's a lovely form of exercise and, you know, yeah, I should get on to that.
Are you nervous about this year, Strictly? Because obviously, you know, he's going to be paired with someone else. It'll feel quite strange for you.
It will be a bit odd, but I guess I've got to be cool and aloof and laid back about it, haven't I?
Yeah.
Won't turn up to rehearsals every day. Right, what are you doing? But I think it's just, you know, I was in it last year. I've got to allow the next person. I'm quite excited to watch it and enjoy it this year, you know.
Because you'll understand what they're all going through.
I know,
good
yes.
luck with the rest of the run of Pygmalion. Like I say, it's until the 3rd of September at the Garrick.
Comes on the
15th. Good luck, Alistair. As Cara Toynton, everyone. That is all for today. Tune in tomorrow when we're joined by John Barrowman and the lovely Brian Connolly. And we'll be saying a fond farewell to our Colleen. It's our last show tomorrow. Don't miss it, 12:30.